No giant can stop you, because he holds your hand. That's a powerful song. He holds our hand. Nothing can stop you. That's what we have to remember. Nothing can stop us. Nothing can stop us. I don't care what giant the enemy put in front of you. Can't nothing stop you tonight. Nothing. Because who we walk with, who we belong to, who we are, can't nothing stop you tonight. I mean nothing. You just got to know who you are in Christ Jesus. He holds your hand. Oh, yes, he does. Oh, yes, he does. Jesus. Yes, he does. Yes. Yes. Yes, Lord Jesus. Yes. Just to be able to talk to him. Oh, yes. I love that song, you all. That song, you all. Oh, my God. I belong to him. He walks with me. He talks with me. He reveals to me who I am. He shows me. He's spirit, and spirit and in truth. He's God all by himself. And he holds all powers in his hand. No spirit is greater than the Holy Spirit. No spirit is greater than the Holy Spirit. No spirit, you all. I don't care what the enemy try to tell you. I don't care what the enemy try to do. Nobody greater than Christ Jesus. Nobody greater than the Holy Spirit. Nobody, you all. You just have to know who you are in Christ Jesus. And then you have to know him in all his glory. He's so powerful. Let's pray, you all. Let's pray. I'm sorry, y'all. It's the other phone ringing. Let's pray. I should have cut it off. It's my father's phone. Busy. As soon as I get ready to pray, that phone start ringing. We're gonna pray. I had to go see about my daughter. Never could have made it. We serve an awesome God. Regardless of what we go through, regardless of what the enemy throw our way, regardless of every trial and every tribulation, God is still God. God still sits on the right-hand side of the Father, our Lord and our Savior, making intercessions for us. So regardless of what you're going through, regardless of what trial or what tribulation that you're in right now, I want you to know tonight that God have already found a way out for you. He's already made a way out for us. And so that's why in every trial and tribulation, we have to give thanks. We have to still lift him up. We have to still bring glory to him. Regardless of what go on in our lives, God is still God. And I think once we, as His people, come to that place in our lives, that regardless of what we go through, regardless of whatever the enemy bring our way, that we can still thank God, that we can still bring glory to His name. That's when you have got to a place in your walk with God, that sanctification, that you have been set aside to be used by God. Because now He already knows that whatever you go through, you're going to praise Him. That whatever you go through, you're going to thank Him. And so tonight, you all, we're going to pray, and we're going to continuously walk with Him. We're going to continuously to thank Him. We're going to continuously to give Him the glory through it all, through every test and through every trial. Father God, we come before Your throne of grace tonight. We come, some needing one thing and some needing another. But Father, we come before Your throne of grace tonight just to say thank You. We come tonight to lift You up. We come tonight, Father God, to say that we love You. Father God, we thank You for Your word tonight. We thank You for the blood, Father God. We thank You tonight in the name of Jesus, for we know that Your word will not return to Your void. We thank You for the Holy Spirit. We thank You for His presence, Father God, for we know that when we're in His presence, that all things are going to be okay. Everything is going to be okay. We know that when we walk with Him and when we talk with Him, that everything is going to be okay. And Father God, tonight, we just want to say thank You. We just want to glorify You, because we know tonight that as we walk by grace, as we walk by faith, that we know that everything is going to be okay, because You have already found a way out of escape for us. You have already fixed those situations, everyone that come before Your throne and Your grace, that needing something tonight, those that need to be healed, those that need their minds regulated. That we know tonight, Father God, that You have already fixed it. You have already fixed that financial situation. You have already fixed it about that job. You have already fixed that child. You have already fixed that marriage. You have already fixed that husband and that wife. And it's only through faith that we know, by faith, that You have already worked it out. And tonight, we just want to say thank You for fixing every situation, Father God, that the enemy bring out way. We thank You for Sister Tammy's son. We thank You for what You're doing in his life. We thank You for laying Your mighty hands upon him. We thank You tonight that You will raise him up and use him for Your glory. We thank You tonight, Father God, for her as a mother. We thank You tonight for that family. We thank You tonight for Sister Pam Kenny G. We thank You for her tonight, Father God. We thank You for her that You are renewing her mind tonight. We thank You for the others, Tammy 333, Father God, that You're doing a work within her heart, even though death come. Father God, we thank You tonight, for we know that You are touching her in her heart. We know that You are keeping her even through hard times. Father God, tonight, we just want to say thank You. We know that every spirit that try to come against us, we know that You are binding them. We know tonight, Father God, that when You open one door, You will close another door. We know tonight, Father God, that by faith, that by faith, Father God, that we are healed by Your stripes, Father God. We know, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that as You went to the cross for our sins, Father God, that we can have life and have it more abundantly through You, Lord Jesus. And tonight, we just want to say thank You. We don't want to ask You for anything, but we just want to bring glory to You. We just want to lift You up. We just want to say thank You for everything You have done and everything You're going to do in our lives. We just want to say thank You that we can be healed by Your stripes, that every stripe that You took on the cross, that it brings healing to us by faith. And tonight, we thank You for a measure of faith, and we thank You for Your Holy Spirit. We thank You for His presence. We thank You for Him speaking through a yielded vessel, Father God, that have nothing within them. And tonight, we just want to say thank You. We thank You, Father God, for Your word, for we know that Your word will do what it's sent out to do. We know that Your word is going to bring healing tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we know that everyone on this site, Father God, that needs something for You, that You have already worked it out tonight. We know through every trial and tribulation that You are making character in us. And we know through every trial and tribulation revelation that you're revealing yourself to us. And tonight, we just want to say thank you for the revelation. We thank you for opening up spiritual eyes and deaf ears tonight. We just want to say thank you for everything that you're doing in our lives in the spiritual realm. We just want to say thank you. Father God, we thank you for the presence of the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Father God, that no flesh will glory in your presence. Father God, we just tonight want to say thank you. We thank you, for we know that you are moving. We know that you are always working. We know that you are always fixing things for our good and for your glory. And tonight, we just want to say thank you, even for your glory. We thank you, Father God, for everything that you have done in the midst of your people. We thank you for every miracle that you allowed to take place in the midst of your people. We thank you tonight, Father God, even for the blood that still speaks for us today. We thank you tonight for the word that still speaks for us today. We thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, for the Holy Spirit that will draw to him. We thank you for the drawing tonight, Father God. We thank you, Father God, that you help us and you lift us up even as we press our way. Father God, we thank you. We thank you, Father God, even for that measure of faith that you put within each one of us. We thank you for the gift of faith tonight. We thank you for the baptism of the Holy Spirit tonight. Father God, we thank you for the anointing tonight. Father God, we thank you for allowing us to get up this morning, even in our right minds this morning. We just want to say thank you for another morning that we didn't even know that we would make it through another morning. But it's only through your grace and your mercy that you allowed us to get up this morning. It's only through your grace and your mercy that you allowed us to go through this day. It's only through your grace and your mercy that you allow us to sit here tonight. It's only through your grace and your mercy that you allow your word to come forth. It's only through your grace and your mercy that the Holy Spirit is drawing tonight. It's only through your grace and your mercy that you gave us your only begotten son. It's only through your grace and your mercy that you gave us an inheritance. It's only through your grace and your mercy that we can have life and have it more abundantly. It's only through your grace and your mercy that healing will take place tonight. It's only through your grace and your mercy that minds will be renewed tonight. It's only through your grace and your mercy that everything that your people go through, that you are there to lift us up. It's only through your grace and your mercy that you put a hedge around us. It's only through your grace and your mercy that you lay your mighty hands upon those with COVID. It's only through your grace and your mercy that the enemy can't touch us unless you allow it. It's only through your grace and your mercy, Father God, tonight that your love will run from breast to breast. It's only through your grace and your mercy that peace is restored within your people. It's only through your grace and your mercy that joy is restored within your people. It's only through grace and in your mercy that peace is restored within your people. It's only through your grace and your mercy that joy is grace and your mercy that the Holy Spirit can dwell within us and bring praises up for our Lord and our Savior. It's only through your grace and your mercy tonight. And your people come tonight just to say thank you. We come tonight to honor you. We come tonight to give you all glory. We come tonight to praise your most holy and precious name. We come tonight just to say thank you. Because sometime we know, Father God, that we fail just to say thank you. And tonight, Father God, your people come by faith just to say thank you. We stand on your word tonight just to say thank you. We stand, Father God, by faith and to say thank you. And Father God, in the name of Jesus, that even as the Holy Spirit have his way tonight, that he draws tonight, we thank you tonight for salvation. We thank you for the blood, Father God. And tonight, Father God, we thank you for the Lamb of God. We thank you for your only begotten Son, Father God. You said that when he lifted up, that he will draw. And Father God, we thank you for your drawing spirit tonight. We thank you for the souls that will give their lives to you tonight, for it's only through grace and mercy. And tonight, we just want to say thank you. We thank you for allowing us, Father God, to be able to even clothe and dress ourselves, even in our right minds tonight. We just want to say thank you. Father God, we thank you for clothing us in your righteousness. And we thank you tonight for clothing us, even washing us in your blood. And we thank you tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus, for your word that dwells within our hearts. We thank you tonight for giving us a clean heart and renewing in us the right spirit. We thank you tonight for just allowing us as your people to walk with you. We thank you tonight, Father God, that it's through every trial and tribulation that you will reveal yourself to your people. And tonight, we just want to say thank you. Tonight, we just want to lift you up. Tonight, we want to come together as one, in one body, in one mindset, and lift you up. And tonight, we want to say thank you. Father God, we're going to give you all glory tonight because it belongs to you. And you're worthy tonight to be lifted up. You are so worthy tonight to be lifted up. And we as your people, we come in one mindset, and that's to lift you up. And we thank you tonight. In the name of Jesus, Father, we come on one accord. We come on one accord to say thank you. We thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, your people come together and we say amen and amen and amen, because we will bring glory to your name tonight, Father God. Father, we will only lift up your name. Amen and amen and amen and amen and amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. There is no greater glory than Christ Jesus. There is no greater glory on this universe, in this world, than Christ Jesus. He's all power. You're Jesus and he's in you. You cannot be taken out of his hand, because he said, not the vessel that you will bring forth. And I just want to say thank you, because I know that word will mend hearts tonight. And I know it will go out to renew minds tonight. And I know that it will turn to you void, that your word will go out and heal tonight in the name of Jesus. That mine in the name of Jesus. I give you all glory tonight for her life. I thank you for her, everything you have allowed in her life and everything you will allow in her life. I thank you for God in the name of Jesus, for you sit high and you look low. I thank you, Father God, allowed to be on this live tonight. I thank you, Father God, for touching their hearts and their minds. And I know that it's through your grace and your mercy, Father God, that people can Father God, but it's only through your grace and it's only through your mercy, Father God, that we are grace setting us free. We thank you for grace having its way. We thank you to through grace, and tonight we thank you, Father God, for the Holy Spirit. We thank you for him of you, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for allowing him to alter our footsteps. We just want to say thank you for allowing him to alter our footsteps, which way to go. We thank you tonight, for we know that it's you that keeps a hedge around our children and protect them from all evilness. And we know that you keep evilness back. It's only through your grace and your mercy that you have kept death a halt tonight. It's only through your grace and your mercy that sickness can't go no further. Receive your word tonight. It's through grace and mercy. And Father God, tonight we your peace, that we can have peace even through trials and tribulations. It's only through we know that it's you that speak and tell peace to come into our lives. We know that you are down inside of us, unspeakable joy and full of glory. And tonight, for being God, we thank you for the sweet Lamb of God. We know that Father God, that he's the chief cornerstone. We know tonight, Father God, that he's the Alpha and Omega. We know, Father God, tonight that he's our peace in the midst of the storm. We know everything that the enemy bring our way, we know only that it's through you. We thank you tonight, Father God, that it's you that draw us to you. To draw us even to you. And tonight we thank you for such beauty. Everything that you're going to do in the midst of your people, in the mighty say thank you tonight, just to say we love you, just to say that in every want to say on any other night to say that we love you. We want you to know tonight that we love you. We love you. And we thank you for allowing your love to run from breast to breast. We thank you. We thank you for your peace, God, for everything he's going to do in the midst of your people, because we welcome him. We enjoy his presence. We bow before you. We just want to say thank you in your presence. We enjoy your presence. We inhabit your praises. We thank you tonight. We come before your throne of grace tonight to be able to come before your throne of grace. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you tonight, Father. We thank you and we give you all. Amen and amen. And amen, you all. And amen. And we thank God. It's through his grace and his mercy that we are here tonight. It's nothing that we do so tonight, because you know he's God. He's God, and he holds all power in his hand. He tell death to be still when death try to come our way. He's the one that speak to death and say, don't come no further. He's the one that can say, peace be still in our lives. Even when the enemy tries to come in like a flood, it's only through the grace of God that he speaks to peace and tell peace to come into our lives. And sometimes, you know, we feel like God can't do the things that we need him to do, but it's nothing too hard for God. It's nothing in our lives that's too big for God. God is God, and he hold all power. He that's in us is greater than he that's in the world. It's no spirit greater than the Holy Spirit. It's no God greater than Jehovah. It's just no God. It's no one that's great. So if you want to serve another God, you need to go back and think, what is the one that went to the cross for our sins? He's the one that said, no man taketh my life. But say, listen, that by my stripes are you healed. He's the one that everything that... When he went to the cross and they began every lash that he took, every lash he took for us, that's why he said, by my stripes are you healed. Why? Every stripe that he took, every lash that they whipped him in his back, it was for us. It was for our healing. It was for our transgression. It was nothing that it was for us, because he said, no man taketh my life, but I lay it at the cross, that he will go, that we might have life and we might have it more abundantly. Not only did he go that we might have life and have it more abundantly, he went that we could have peace. He went that we could have joy. He went that we could have grace and full of glory. And so tonight we should be ready to lift him up. For the work that he done, because we don't have to do anything. All we have to do is yoke. And when we yoke up with him, all we got to do now is walk with him. We should go in saying, holy, holy, holy. We should go in our churches. Lifting him up. We should come on these lives. Wherever you go, we should be lifting up the name of Jesus for everything that he done for us. He didn't do it for us. You may be healed tonight. That I may be healed tonight. That our children might be healed tonight. To do everything that he's doing in the midst of the people, we should come on here thanking him for the we do. We should come in praising him. We should come in giving him all glory. We should. He took every lash that when they poured out his beard, it wasn't for him, but and as they did everything, they humiliated him, because they took off his clothes and and they put him naked to the cross, but it wasn't for him, it was for us. That everything that he did when he went to the cross, he did it for us. He did it that we may be able to come before the throne of grace, and we may be able to come boldly before the throne of grace, that the veil would be ripped from the top. And he went to the cross that we might have life and have it more abundantly. And sometimes we forget who we serve, because he's a mighty God. He's an awesome God. And sometimes our minds can't conceive the God that he is. Sometimes our mind can't conceive of a man going to the cross and a man allowing transgressions. And yet we don't begin to understand what he did when he went to the cross. He did it for us, and we forget that when it's time to praise him, we forget that this is not about anything of us. All he asks of us is that we believe and that we trust in the one that he is, the living Son of God. And tonight, if you can just stand on the word of the living God and begin to say, Lord, I thank you. I thank you for everything you've done in my life. I thank you for my children. I thank you for my family. I thank you for my job. I thank you for making a way out of no way. I thank you for my healing. I thank you for my family's healing. I thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that everything that you've done from Calvary, you did it for your people. You did it that we might have life and have it more abundantly. You did it because you love us. You did it that you yet loved us even when we were sinners. You still loved us, and that is too much love that he would allow himself to be beaten and to be humiliated. Why? For mankind. He loved mankind so much until even after they nailed him to the cross and they pierced him in his side, he dropped his head and said, Father, it is finished. He say, forgive them, for they know not what they do. When he come, and he come on this earth, he come looking to the cross, and when he come, and at the end, he said, Father, it is finished. I've finished the work that you gave me to do. I've redeemed them back to you. I've given them back to you. I'm presenting my blood back to you. For your people, for your children. And even as he presented the blood back to the Father on our behalf, that we might have life and have it more abundantly. And sometimes people can't even praise him. People can't even say thank you. People can't even lift up holy hands. People can't even say I love you. Afraid of people looking at them. Afraid of who gonna see them because they lift up holy hands. But I'm telling you, as Lord and Savior and the living Spirit of God begins to dwell within you, he seals you, he teaches you, he alters your footstep, he gives you a light that will glow from the inside to the outside. He manifests itself within your heart, and it will manifest from the inside to the outside, that the world will see Christ Jesus, the hope of glory within you, because you take on the Spirit of the living God that dwells within your heart. And sometimes we as his people don't want to lay down this old flesh. We don't want to give it all to him. We want to keep one foot in the world and one foot trying to walk with him. We're trying to go to a holy God in the natural and stay in sin. We don't want to give it all to him, but yet, He said, I let no man have to take my life. He said, I lay it down for the sheep. And even after they nailed him to him, lashes on his back, they beat him to where you couldn't even tell he was a man. shaking, and he dropped his head and said, Father, it is finished. He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And so do we think that we will be able to escape, that we will not want to give it all to God, that we still want to do the things of the world, but yet God say, be ye in the world, but not of the world. And so if God gave us his only begotten son, he gave. Us, then all he said is that we love God with all our hearts, with all our minds, with all our strength, and to love one another as he loved us. That's all he asked of us. And we as man can't even love him with all our hearts, all our minds, all our strength. We can't love him enough to just lift up holy hand and say, Lord, I thank you. I thank you, Father God. We are so worried about who gonna see us when we begin to praise God. We so busy, worried about they gonna think it don't take all that. But I'm gonna tell you, in my life, it take all that and some more. He had to come way out and get me. He didn't just have to go by the seashore. He had to go way out and get me. And so now, much is required for much is given. And I'm telling you tonight, when he began to come out and he began to woo you in, and yet church, and we don't know how to lay it all down for him, and we don't know how. Out of him, our life. We don't know how to just lay it all down for him. We don't know how to. We will come on this live with one mindset, and that's to lift up the. Name Jesus. We wouldn't come in with all this foolishness. We wouldn't come in with all our mess, but we will come in if we truly knew him. If you truly knew Christ Jesus in all of his glory, you wouldn't have time for the foolishness. The only thing you're going to have time for is to know that one day every knee going to bow and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus Christ is the living son. Nail prints in his hands and the piercing in his side and the piercing in his feet. For him, our holy God, and we have lived any kind of way, we're going to be ashamed. So when you come on these lives and you come on, you should come in with one mindset. To just say, Lord, I'm here tonight to bring praises to your name. I'm here tonight to lift you up. I'm here tonight to glorify you. Because you said that when you're lifted up, you will draw all mankind to you. And all we want to see is mankind be drawn to you. Because we are the salt of the earth. And if we are the salt of the earth, we are seasoning in the earth today. So all we come on to do is to see souls get saved. And now, Father God, even when he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Don't you know today? That's what the blood is saying. The blood is still speaking today. The blood is saying, forgive them, that they have received for us. He's still interceding for us. Why? Through the word. He's the word. He's the word. He's the word. The word was with God. Go to 1 John 1:1. I want you to go to John 1:1. In the beginning was the word. In the beginning was what? In the beginning was the word. And the word was what? The word was with God. And the word was God. And so if the in the beginning was word, the written word still speaks for you today. Because what? The written word is God to God. When we begin to say, Lord, by your stripes are we healed, the word . when we pray and we say, Father God, by your stripes are we healed. Don't you? Know that the word of God is being sent out? Don't you know that he said that my word would not return to me void? That everything that the word is sent out to do, it will, Lord, by your stripes are we healed? That means that the word of God is going forth. It's unless we are not receiving it by faith. But if we send it out, if we send in our minds, it will go out to draw souls. And so, but we got to be on one mindset. The word of the living God. See, when you go in prayer, prayer is just talking to God to take down the enemy. And so when we begin to know that this word have come to know that this word is going to become your life, this word is going to become your so by faith, it won't be nothing that this word won't be able to do in a company's power to our lives. It's the word that's still living. If the word was in the and attain the word and have no power, because all power belongs to Christ Jesus. I want you to go to John 1 and 1, and now I see why he took me to John 1 and 1. And the word was God. And the word was what? The word was God. And so if you believe in this word tonight, if we say that we trust God, if we say we got faith to Genesis, that God, everything that he spoke through the word. So now it's telling us in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. He, look at that, you all. He with God. He is who? He is the word. It called him he, because the word of God. God is Christ Jesus. The word that was in God was Jesus. So it said he was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him. Anything made that was made. Without the word, nothing in this universe was made without the word. Without who? Without him. Who is him? Christ Jesus. Without him, nothing in this universe was made. So everything, not something, everything. How in the world can we possess that we cannot begin to speak the living word, and things have to begin to live in God when we begin to pray his word? And so it says now, it says, uh, In him was what, you all? In him was life. I want you to underline that word, life. And went to the cross, the word. He came and brought life to who? To mankind. It's says that, and the darkness has not overcome it. He that's in you is greater than he that's in the world. He that's in you is greater than he that's in the world. The darkness cannot. Overcome anything within you. Now I want you to turn to Genesis 1 and 1. Go to Genesis, you all. I want you to go to Genesis chapter 1. I want you to go to Genesis chapter 1. Genesis what? 1 and 1, verse 1. Now we're going to go back to Genesis, the Old Testament, where God began to create the universe. He began to create the world. Because first you got to know how. When everything else passed, he said the word of God will stand. In the beginning, it said, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And the earth was without void. It was without form and it was without void. And darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. So here we see the Father, we see the Son, and we see the Holy Spirit. We see the waiting, and the Holy Spirit, it said, is hovering over the world. He's hovering. Thing into being. And so it says now I'm in verse 2, and it says light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness, and God, but we see God at work, what, with his word. And so everything that God did, the word was with God and the word was God. So we see the word in the beginning. In Genesis 3, but yet 1. And it says, and God. No, I went too far over. And God said, let there be an expanse in the midst of the waters. And you go to the beach and you see all this water. And then you got the sand right there. And then further than what God allowed it to come. What did he do? He holds everything back. Why? Through his existing, through the word. Why? Because everything that God spoke was good. Everything God did, he did through the word. The same word that obtained, the same word that God began to create the universe with, that had all power, that did all creation. And yet we got that same word that dwells down on the inside of us. We got the same spirit, the Holy Spirit, that dwells within our hearts. And we have no power. We have no power. We can't speak
making these delicious
know who you are. You got to know what you contain. You contain the spirit of the living God. You contain the word of the living God. Now listen to what he said. He says now, he said, and God said, let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place. What did he say? Let the waters up under the heavens be what? Gathered together into one place. So that's how you can see the oceans. That's how you can see all that water into one place, because the word spoke. The word said, let all that water stay in one place. See, everything that the Father done, everything that the word did, said, the word had to not return void. And so what do? That word hold all that water back into place. And so everything that God did, he said it was good. And so now he said, and God said, let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear. So now you see the ocean. You see how we got the ocean. And so now you see how the dry land is appearing. And I'm showing you this, that you would have to begin to believe that Jesus Christ is the living Son of God. That Jesus Christ, that everything that was spoken, it was spoken through God, through the word. And so everything that the word is doing today, which is holding everything in its place, God is holding everything in its place through the word. And so that same word that God is holding everything in its place is dwelled within his people. The same spirit that's holding over and over the earth is the same Holy Spirit that's in us, but yet we have no power. But yet he said that we would do greater works than what we seen with the 12 disciples. He said that we would do greater works. And so now he began to go back, and God said, let the earth sprout vegetation, plants yielding seeds, and fruit trees bearing fruit in which is their seed. So he's saying that everything have to bear within its own self. Everything produces after its own self. Every apple tree have to produce an apple tree. Every orange tree have to produce an orange tree. Everything in the ocean have to produce after its own kind. Everything that God made, he made in order. Everything have to produce in its own kind. Evolution could not do that. Evolution couldn't just began to come into being, and everything just create, and everything come to produce after its own kind. And so now we begin to say, and it says, and let's go down. And God said, let the earth sprout vegetation, plants yielding seeds, and fruit trees bearing fruit in which is their seeds, each according to its kind on the earth. And it was what? It was so. And the earth brought vegetation, plants yielding seeds according to their own kind. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seeds according to their own kind. And it says, and God said, let there be light in the expansion of the heavens to separate the day from the night. And let them be signs for seasons. Let them be signs for seasons. What do we see that's creating the universe? We see the word of the living God speaking the word, which is the Son of God that holds all power. And the Father is speaking, and everything that he's speaking is the word that he's bringing into being. And yet the Holy Spirit is there that's expanding over the face of the earth. And then he began to say, and it said, and God said, let there be light in the expansion of the heavens, and to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons. Now you know how you get the seasons, and for days and for years. Now you see how we get days and years. And it says, and let them be lights in the expansions in the heavens to give light. To do what? To give light upon the earth. Y'all, this is, y'all, how can we overlook the word of God? When the word tells us how you get years, how you get seasons, how you get the days, how all that water at the ocean is in one place, how it's separated from the land, from the waters. God gives us everything right here. How can you not know that the word of God is real? Who else have given you an explanation how you get the years, how you get the seasons, how you get vegetation, how everything produces after its own kind? How in the world can you not know that God is real? How can anybody look at this universe and now not see the creator after the creation? Because we see there the great creation, but people will rather praise the creation and not praise the God that made the creation. Something is wrong with man. He said that man becomes so smart till he become foolish. He becomes so wise till he become foolish. And then he began to go on and he said, let's go over. I want you to go down to verse 27. It says, So God created man, what? In his own image. God created man, what? In his own image. And in the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, he said, be what? He said, be fruitful and multiply. He said, and fill the earth and subdue it. Don't y'all know? He said, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the heavens and over every living thing that moves on the earth. And God said, behold, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is on the face of the earth, and every tree with seeds in its fruit. You shall have them for food. We shall have them for food. Listen, you all, and to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the heavens, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, everything that has breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. And it was what? And it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was good. It was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning in the sixth day. How in the world can we see everything in the heavens? How can you see the creation and not realize that there is a creator? Because nothing creates itself. Everything have to start from something. But nobody have ever been able to tell man how the days become to be, how the night become to be, how the earth began to create everything in its own image, like a tree have to bear a tree, and animals have to bring its own kind. Nobody have ever been able to give you the word that to tell you how creation was brought into being, except the word of the living God. The word of God have been the only thing that can give you an explanation of how this creation was brought into being. And we take the word of the living God and we throw it aside on our coffee tables. We throw it aside and never pick it up. And yet all the answers that people come on his lives and begin to ask is in the word of the living God. He said everything that he made, it was good. And he began to show us how the years come, how the seasons come, how he began to make man in his own image, how he took breath in his breath, and he breathed it into man, and man become a living soul, because man didn't come a living soul until God put his breath down on the inside of man, and it said that man become a living soul. And so today we began to stand and say that we are serving a holy God, and we are trying to go to him in the flesh, because we don't want to believe that this word is the living word. We don't want to believe that the word of God that he created the universe with, that word dwells down on the inside of you, and it's like fire shut up in your bones. He told the woman at the well, he said, I'll give you living water. Jesus Christ will give you living water if you accept him as Lord and Savior. If you get your eyes off of the world and begin to put your eyes on Jesus Christ, and when the enemy, and the Bible tells us that we're going to have trials, we're going to have tests, we're going to have tribulation. And so when the Bible, the word of the living God began to tell us that testing time is come, that trying time is come, we have got to get our house in order. We got to begin to get this word. Stop throwing this word aside. You need to get into the word. You need to begin to go before the throne of grace and ask God to reveal himself to you. You need to go before the throne of grace and ask the Holy Spirit to put peace down on the inside of you, to take that old stone stony heart that's causing conflict and causing confusion, and to give you a heart of flesh, that you will be well, have the love of God within your heart, that we don't hurt one another, that we don't beat one another, but we only have the love of the living God down on the inside of us, that love can run from breast to breast, and we don't have to try to hurt one another. We don't have to beat one another, but that we love one another, that we lift one another up, like he said. He said, the world will know my people for the love that they have one for another. He began to give the last two commandments. He said, I didn't come to do away with the world, but I come to fulfill the word. I come to live, fulfill the law. He said, I didn't come to do away with the law. I come to fulfill the law, that when I put my law within the hearts of my people, that it will be my law that I have lived. He lived the law. He lived every point of the law. He lived every tittle of the law. That when he began to give you that new heart, and when the law of God is put within your heart, why? Because Christ Jesus lived it, and now that he puts it within his people, now you have lived it through him. And so I want you to go on over. I want you to go on over. When he began to say, listen, I want you to go down to verse 20. He said, the man gave names to all livestock and to all the birds and to all the heavens and to every beast of the field. It said, but for Adam, there was not found a helper fit for him. But for Adam, there was not found a helper fit for him. And so the Lord caused a deep sleep. And so now we see now the first surgery. We see the first surgery was done in the Garden of Eve, because it says, and the man, no, I'm going back. And then the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him. Now out of the ground, the Lord God had formed every beast of the field and every bird of heavens, and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was his name. He would call them. That would be the name that he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was his name. The man gave names to all the livestock. I got to slow down. And to the birds of the heavens and to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found a helper fit for Adam. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep. So we see the first surgery to fall upon the man. And while he slept, he took one of his ribs and he closed up his place with flesh. He closed up his place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man that he made into a woman, and brought her to the man. Okay, I'm going back over that. He caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man. And while he slept, he took one of his ribs and closed up his place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. And then the man said, this at last is what? Bone of my bone. I want the men on here to listen to what God said when he took the rib out of the man. He closed up the flesh, and this is what he said. He said, this is what Adam is beginning to say. He said, this at last is bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of the man. We don't even know how to love one another. We don't even know, men don't even know how to treat the one that God said, listen, I'm going to take her out of your rib. I'm not going to take her where you can walk behind her. I'm not going to take her where you can walk before her, but I'm going to take her from your rib. I'm going to take her that you can walk beside her. And as he began to take and close up Adam, and he told Adam, Adam said, now this is bone of my bone, and this is flesh of my
my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. And so the woman that you marry, the one that God give you, is the closest thing that God can give you. He said, now they no longer become two, but they become one. So how can you take something that God has given you that was so precious and begin to treat her any kind of way and begin to walk on her any kind of way? And women, how can we take what God have given us that was so precious that he took us out of his rib and made woman out of him, and we begin to take husbands for granted? We begin to walk over them. We begin not to lift them up. We begin not to let them walk in their position. We begin not to let them be who God called them to be. He called them out as kings. He called them out as priests. How in the world can we begin to look at one another and begin to do the things that we do one to another? How in the world can we hurt one another as we hurt one another, when God said, I took the rib from the man and began to make the woman, and now she's bone of my bone and she's flesh of my flesh? And it says, therefore a man shall leave his father and his mother and be whole and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become what? One flesh. They shall become one flesh. And the man and his wife were both naked and were not ashamed. They were both naked and they were not ashamed. And it says, now the serpent was more crafty. He was, listen, y'all, he was more crafty than any other beast of the field that the Lord God had made. The same way he was crafty back then, he's crafty today. The same way he was tanned down back then, he's tanned up today. The same way that God gave Adam and Eve the word and say, if you eat, you will surely die. That same word is today. If you don't accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you shall surely die. The word of God, the living word of God, is given to you. It's laid out before you. The same way it was laid out for Adam and Eve, the same way that they was in disobedience, it brought death. When we don't accept Christ Jesus as Lord and Savior, death is knocking at the door. Death is creeping at the door. And I'm going to tell you what he said. He said, now the serpent was more crafty than any other beast of the field. He said that the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, did God actually say, you shall not eat of any tree in the garden? And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the tree in the garden. But listen to what she said. She said, but God said, you shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. God didn't tell her she couldn't touch it. See, you see how the word can be given some and not given all? He told her, don't touch it, don't eat it. She said that he told them that they couldn't touch it. That ain't what he said. He said, and the woman said to the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the tree in the garden, but God said, you shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. He didn't say touch, he said eat. And so now you see the word right now being twisted. Now you're seeing the word being half truth. Now you're seeing the word that's not the word, because she said that he said, don't touch it. That ain't what he's saying. And so it said, but the serpent said, I want you to listen to this, because he's doing the same thing today. He said, but the serpent said to the woman, you will surely not die. What do the serpent tell us today? You got time. Just do what you want to do. You got time. You know, you can get saved later on. You ain't got to do it right now. God just don't want you to enjoy your life. He whispered all the things he whispered to Eve. He's still whispering today. You shall not eat of the fruit. Verse 4. It says, but the serpent said to the woman, you will not surely die. For God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be open and you will be like God, knowing good from evil. This is how man now have a conscience to know good from evil, because of what Eve did, because she was disobedient to what? To the word. And so now it says, now He was trying to dishonor God. He made God look bad in front of Eve the same way he do us today. Why do you think these people come on here today saying, well, why do God let so much evilness happen in the world? This is from the enemy. Why do God not stop this from happening, of that from happening? That's from the enemy. Same thing he did with Eve, he's doing today. And so he said, now, listen, it said, but the serpent said to the woman, you will surely not die. You will not surely die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be open, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil. So when the woman saw that the tree, what did she do, y'all? She saw it, her eyes. Our eyes deceive us. Our eyes can be a deceiver. It says now, and so the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be what? To be desired. And the tree was to be desired to make one what? To make one wise. She took of its fruit and ate, and she gave also to her husband who was with her, and he ate. And then the eyes of both were open, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves lion clothes. And they heard the sound. Verse 8, get this. They heard what? They heard the sound of the Lord. They didn't say that God was in the garden. Look what it's saying. Look what this is saying. It said that, and they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden of the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. But the very thing that God told them not to touch, that they touch, now they're hiding themselves behind the very things that God told them not to eat. And what they do, they ate. What they doing now? They hiding behind the very thing that they discerned was disobedient with. And but look at this, you all. This is what I wanted y'all to get right here. Verse 8, and they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from what? The presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, where are you? And he said, I heard, that's powerful. Y'all need to underline that, because what I'm finna tell you, I heard the sound of your voice in the garden, and I was what? I was afraid, because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, who told you you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree of which I commanded you not to eat? And the man said, the woman who you gave me to be with me, she gave me the fruit of the tree, and I ate. And then the Lord God said to the woman, what is this that you have done? And the woman said, the serpent deceived me, and I ate. And the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, cursed are you above all the livestock and above all the beasts of the field. On your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put envy between you and the woman, and between your offsprings and her offsprings. He shall bruise your heel, and you shall bruise his heel. And to the woman he said, I will surely multiply your pain in childbirth. In pain you shall bring forth children. Your desire shall be contrary to your husband, but he shall rule over you. And Adam, he said, because you have listened to the voice, to the voice of your wife, and have eaten of the tree, he said, of which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. He said, cursed is the ground because of you. That's why you have to work the ground today. He said, cursed is the ground because of you. In pain you shall eat of it all the days of your life. He said, thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. But He said, by the sweat of your face, you shall eat bread till you return. Listen to what he said. He said, till you return to the ground. Till you return to the ground. For out of it you were taken, for you are dust, and dust to you shall return. Glory be to God. Glory be to the word of God. When God asked Adam, I got to cut this light off, y'all, because it's so hot. He asked Adam, he said, Adam, where art thou? Adam said, listen, he said, I heard what? I heard the sound. He heard God. He didn't see God. No man had ever seen God and lived. That's what God told Moses. When Moses said, let me see your glory, God said, no man have ever been face to face with me and lived. And so now Adam said, I heard you. He said, I heard your word. I heard you in the garden. And so now when God asked Adam, he said, who told you you was naked? Do y'all know who told Adam he was naked? It was the word of the living God. The same word that God gave to us today is the same word that was walking in the garden of Eve that come down and talk with Adam. It was the word of the living God. The same word that we have today that come down and talk to us is through the word of the living God. We have the same word. We have the same opportunity that Adam had is to do communion with God, to have communion and talk with God. And that's what he did with Adam. Adam said, listen, when I heard you in the garden walking, he said, listen, he heard the sound of God. That was the word of the living God. And so now Adam have hid themselves. Why? Because he's been deceived from the enemy. The same way we are today. We're trying to hide. We're trying to hide away from God. You cannot hide from God. That's why he told Eve. He said, what have you did? Do you see how they shift the blame one to another? The same way we do today, we shift the blame to our parents. Well, I don't do right because my mama didn't do right. My daddy didn't do right. Well, I didn't. The devil made. You ever see people say, the devil made me do it? God ain't wanting to hear nothing except, do you know my son? All God gonna want to know from his people is, do you know my son? And so now, the same word that convicted Adam and Eve, because he told Eve and Adam, he said, who told you you was naked? Who told them they was naked? The word came back to Adam when they ate and the glory left. The word said, you have went against the word of the living God. And today the word will find you in your sin. People is taking this word. This is the word that was in the garden. This is the word that created the universe. This is the word that in the beginning God. This is the word in John 1:1. In the beginning was the word. The word was with God. The word was God. Everything that God made, everything that was created, it was created through the living word of God. It said nothing that was made without the living word of God. How can we take something that's so precious? How can we take the very word that was even in the garden of Eve, and we began to throw it to the side, and it, yet it's the living word of the living God today. How can we not see the glory of the living God in the universe that he made, that he created? He told us how we got the years. He told us how we got the seasons. He told us how we got the months. He told us how the woman was given to man, and how the man say, now this is flesh of my flesh and bone of my bone. He told us how the woman, how when she sinned against God, and God said, because you have done this thing, he said, now I'm going to put a curse on you, that now you're going to have a pain that is no other pain. And we know today as women, there is no other pain like childbirth pain. He told Adam, because you have done this thing, you're going to have to work this ground. You're going to have to eat bread. You will not get nothing out of this ground unless you work it. Today, man cannot eat unless they work the ground. The word of God is still living today. The word of God is still taking form today. He told the serpent, he said, you're going to crawl on your belly. He said, you're going to eat dust. He said, I'm going to put envy between you and the woman. That's why when we see snakes, we don't like snakes. Why? Because he put envy between us and the enemy. And so the snakes. And so now I want to tell you today that it's going to be no excuse. It's going to be no excuse when we turn away from the living God that have given us the living word. The same way he did Adam, and the same way he he did Eve, in the same way he brought the curse upon them because they was disobedient. And now we think that we're going to escape when we are disobedient to the word of the living God, the same word that Adam and Eve had, the same word that convicted Adam and Eve is the same word that will convict man today. You will trip over the word of the living God, which is the Son of the living God, and that's the only thing that will cause you to go to hell. That he said, I will forgive you for every sin except blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. If you die and don't accept Jesus as Lord and Savior, you will be hell bound. It's nothing else that will take you to hell except rejecting Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. The same way that Adam and Eve rejected him is the same way today, but the word will find you out just like it found out Adam and Eve. And if you forsake the same word that Adam and Eve disobeyed, and we disobey it today, what make us think that we're going to escape if he didn't let Adam and Eve escape? What make us think that we're going to escape when he gave us heaven's best? He gave us his only begotten Son. He gave us a part of him. He gave us the word, and the word become living, and the word began, took on flesh, and the word dwelled amongst man, and they beheld his glory, and yet they rejected the glory. How much more today, if we reject the living word of God, that God will not, we will end up in hell, because God will not allow us to go and not be even as Adam and Eve. The same excuse that Adam and Eve gave is what man giving today. We giving the same excuses. We trying to hide the same way Adam and Eve is hiding. We trying to do the very same thing that Adam and Eve is doing. We think that we can so escape. Eve say, that thing look good to my eye. When the enemy sent a man or a woman in your presence, and what do? The same way he deceived Eve back then, he deceiving men and women today. That's why we got so many divorces within the body of the living Christ today. Because why? Our eyes are deceiving us. Everything that look good ain't good. Everything we think is for us is not for us. Everything that we think we need to have, God, no, we don't need it. And so what did he do? He began to move things out of your midst. He began to prune you. He began to cut things away from you. And what do we do? We get angry at God, and we begin to say, why this happening in my life? Why that happening in my life? And don't let him cut somebody away from us. Don't let him begin to pull people out of our lives. What do? We get mad, and what is he doing? He just trying to save us. He trying to save us from all the hurt, from all the heartaches, from all the pain that we will receive if we don't receive the living word of God. Because why? Because we want things like Adam and Eve did. Eve said, that thing looked good to the eye. What do we say? What did it cause Eve? It caused her death. What do it cause us if we're married or if we are in fornication? What will it bring? It brings death. I'm telling y'all, it's the same way with Adam and Eve. The same word is the same word that you have today. You can either accept it or you can reject it, but the word will find you out. The same way the word found out Adam and Eve, the word will find us out today. So we can either accept it or we can reject it. And so glory be to God. Glory be to God. I thank God tonight. I thank him for his word. I thank him for the Holy Spirit. I thank him for his presence. I thank God for just being God. I thank him tonight for holding all power in his hand. I thank him tonight that his word won't return void. I thank him tonight, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that your word will do what it was sent out to do, that it would open up spiritual ears, Father God, that it will give spiritual revelation. For you said that your sheep will know your voice. And tonight, Father God, I thank you that your sheep will know your voice, that they will know your word, that they will know you. And Father God, I thank you tonight for the moving of your spirit. I thank you for everyone that you allowed to be on this live. I thank you for everyone that you are drawing to you right now. I know, Father God, that you said in Romans 10:9, that if we accept Christ Jesus in our heart, if we believe in our heart, and if we confess him with our mouths, that we shall be saved. And we come before your throne of grace tonight. We come tonight, and the ones that want to accept him right now, I want you right today, today. He said, harden not your hearts today. Harden not your hearts to the word, to the living word. I don't want you to harden your hearts. I want you to put up your hands. I want you to confess that you want to know him. You have to put up your hands, or you have to give sign to let us know that you want to come to know him. He said, if you believe in your hearts and we confess with our mouths that we shall be saved. If you want to know the living word today, you all you have to do is confess that Jesus Christ is the living Son of God. It have to be a confession. You have to confess him before the world. You have to confess that Jesus is the living Son of God. You have to know in your heart. You have to repent. You have to know that we are sinners. Why? Because Adam and Eve died when they died in the garden. Why did they die? They was disobedient to the word, and they died in the garden. They didn't die physical death. They died a spiritual death. And the same spiritual death they died to is the spiritual death that man began to be a sinner. All mankind died when Adam and Eve died to the spirit man. When they lost the glory, all mankind lost the glory. One man brought sin into the world, and one man took sin out of the world. Jesus Christ took sin out. Adam brought sin in. And so tonight, if you want to pick up the glory that Adam and Eve laid down, all you got to do tonight is confess that in your heart that Jesus Christ went to the cross for your sins and that he rose for your salvation. Do not neglect the word of the living God tonight, you all, because it's so precious. It's so precious tonight. Do not take it for granted, but you got to know that you know that you know that the word is living, that the word is real, that the word will do everything that it's sent out to do for you. When you begin to know that Jesus Christ is the living Son of God, and you know that this word is living, you know that this word is real, you will walk in this word. You will accept the Holy Spirit in by faith. When you accept Christ Jesus, you accept the same Holy Spirit that raised up Jesus, the same Holy Spirit that hovered over the world, is the same Holy Spirit that dwells within the people of God today. And I thank you for every gift. Thank you so much. Everyone that don't know Christ Jesus, you are just like Adam and Eve. You are rejecting the word of the living God. Do not reject the word. Time is winding up. We are seeing revelation unfold in this generation. This is the generation that it's like a woman that's in childbirth pain. And you all know when a woman get in childbirth pain, women, you know that the pains get stronger and stronger. Every trimester, the pains get stronger and stronger. And this is what we're seeing today. We're seeing the pains. We're seeing revelation. We're seeing it unfold, but the pains are getting stronger and stronger. And to one day, the water goes break. One day when the water breaks and we're going to look up and redemption draws. Now, he said every knee shall bow and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And so tonight, if you want to know him and Son of God, it's, as you say, the Son of Prayer, then you'll be justified in the eyes of God. That's your heart, and what will that be? That's just being justified in the eyes of God. Ain't that beautiful? That the same Creator, the same God. And say, listen, I accept the gift. I accept grace. I accept my Lord and my Savior. I need him. I need him tonight because I am a sinner. I'm a sinner, and I need to be saved. I need a Savior.
I need for someone to come into my life and save me, because I can't do it myself. If I could do it myself, wouldn't need a Savior. And so tonight, I want you tonight to, as we say the sinner's prayer, I want you to know that I'm so wet, that light be so hot. Until if tonight, when we say the sinner's prayer and you say it along with us, all he asking you, he ain't asking you to do nothing except believe that Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins. I want you to just give it all to him. I want you to just say, Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. I'm a sinner and I need a Savior. I accept Jesus as my Lord and my Savior. I repent of my sins. Forgive me of my sins, the ones I know of and the ones I know not of. But I accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, that he come and live his life in me, that by faith I receive Christ Jesus in my heart. I receive him as my Savior. I thank you, Father God, that Jesus Christ will live his life in me. Forgive me of my sins. Wash me in your blood, that now I am born again. Now I'm your child. Now I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. And we thank you, Father. We thank you for salvation. We thank you for the blood. We thank you for the word. Father God, for each one that accepted Jesus Christ right now in their hearts, that asked for forgiveness. Father God, we invite them into the family. We welcome them right now in the family. For Father God, you said if one sinner come home to glory, that we should rejoice just over one sinner. Father God, tonight we are rejoicing. Tonight we thank you. We thank you for salvation. We thank you for repentance. We thank you for the blood. We thank you for the word. We thank you for life tonight. We thank you for everyone that gave their life to you tonight. We thank you for everyone that received Christ Jesus within their hearts tonight. In Jesus' mighty name, Father. Father, we thank you. We glorify you. We magnify you. We accept the Holy Spirit that will dwell within our hearts. In the mighty name of Jesus, right now. Amen, you all. Amen. Amen and amen. To God be the glory. I love you all. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. The living Son of God, you all. Just think, you're walking with the creator of this universe. We're walking with God. That's a gift. That's a, to be able to walk with God. Oh my God, y'all, that is so precious. To be able to walk with the one that created this universe. To walk with a God that's so powerful, that's so mighty. And we can accept him as our Lord and our Savior is a gift from God. It's a gift from God. You know, sometimes people say, well, how Adam and Eve, how could they go against the same way we go against him today? When we don't accept his word, we're doing the same thing Adam and Eve doing. Rejecting the word. So we have the same choice that Adam and Eve had. We have the same choice, you all. Glory be to God. We have the same choice. Yes. Glory be to God. Yes. It is a gift from God, which is grace. Grace means free gift. And the free gift that God gave us is Christ Jesus. Glory be to God. We magnify him. We lift up his most precious name tonight, for he is the Lamb of the living God. And I thank God, you all. I thank God. I didn't know what I was going to preach tonight. All I knew that I was going to John. Because when I got home, glory be to God, I had to go see about my daughter. And so when I got in the house, It was a little after 9. So I had no idea what the Holy Spirit was going to do. But I thank God for the word. I thank God for the anointing. I thank God for everything he have done and everything he's going to do. I thank him for every trial and every tribulation. You know, we should in all things give glory. In all things, we should give glory to God, you all. Oh, baby, is that Sister Gloria? Ether? Is that you, Sister Gloria? Ether? Oh, is that Teresa? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Yes, glory be to God. Glory be to God. Yes, Sister Tim, we should thank him. We should thank him all the time. We should thank our Lord and our Savior. And sometimes we just take it for granted. But to God be the glory. And I thank y'all for the gifts. Y'all know sometimes I don't look at the stream. There's my brother. Hey, Doggy Bag. Don't y'all forget to please follow Doggy Bag. We at 560 something. I need for you all to follow this brother. I need for you all to show him some love and go to his page and follow him. Please, to God be the glory. We love y'all. Yes, to God be the glory. To God be the glory, you all. To God be the glory for the word. He give us the word, because I had no idea. My daughter was on my heart, and I had no idea. But God said, if you yield yourself to God, he will move through you if you yield yourself. And I know I can't do it. And I know if he don't do it, it can't be done. So glory be to God. I love you all. Don't y'all forget to go follow our brother, Tammy. Is that another Tammy? We got a lot of Tammys, don't we? God bless you. God bless you.
Oh, there you are.
Hey, brother. Hey, my brother. DJ. Hey, DJ loves Jesus. Amen. DJ loves Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. Is that Lavender? Yes, he's good, man. He's so awesome. He's so awesome. He's so awesome. When the Holy Spirit can move inside of you and give you a word like he be giving me, and I know it's not me. I know I can't even think like that the way he be bringing it up. I can't even think like that. And so I know it's God. I give him his glory because I know it's not me. And so you have to know that there is a God. I know that there is a God because I know this is not me. I know I don't have the wisdom and the power to preach like this without the moving of the Holy Spirit. I can't even remember scripture at times. He have to bring it to me. And so glory be to God. If it wasn't for the Holy Spirit, I know that he lives because I know that it's him that does the speaking. I know that I didn't even know what I was going to say tonight because I was just running in from after going to see about my daughter. And when I come in here, I was still kind of weighed down about her. And so glory be to God. But look what he did. Look what he did. Look what he did. To God be the glory. I love him. I love you all. And God's will, we will see one another. Yes, he moved mighty. He did. He moved mighty. And I can take no glory. I give him all glory. I give him all glory. All glory belong to him. All glory. And so when you begin to see the power of God moving within you like that, that's when God is revealing himself to you. Because you know it's not you. You know you don't even have that kind of wisdom. I didn't even know that I was going to end up going from Genesis to John. He took me back, and I didn't know that he was going to take me through that. Oh, my God, that was so powerful. Y'all just don't know. No, just don't know, man. So powerful. But to God be the glory. He's awesome. Yes, he's awesome, Marie. And Brother Dramatic, he's awesome. And Tupac, he's awesome. Awesome, awesome. DJ loves Jesus. Amen. Yes, y'all can go on Brother Eric and hear all each night. Brother Eric have each night, the preaching each night. If you want to go back and look at the preaching, Brother Eric will put the... Brother Eric, if you're up here, he will put the website up where you can go on and look at every night's preaching. And you can even share. You can even pull the preaching. And so I don't know whether Brother Eric is on here, whether, and tomorrow we're going to do an interview. We were supposed to do it today, you all, but I had forgotten today, and I couldn't do it today because of my phone. And so, but we will do it tomorrow. I'm going to call him so we can do it tomorrow. And to God be the glory. And I love you all. And so I will see you all tomorrow night. God's will. I will see you all tomorrow night. And tonight, may the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, may he rest and abide on each one of us. May the sweet Holy Spirit rest and abide on each one of us until we meet again. Even though we leave this life, we never leave the presence of Almighty God. We never leave the presence of Christ Jesus. That we walk in the Holy Spirit. That we stay in his presence. And that each one of us have a peaceful, peaceful night tonight. Sister Tammy, may God continuously to rest on your son. May he continuously to breathe through your son. May he continuously to rise him up in the mighty name of Jesus. May he continuously to do a work through him and use him for his glory. Father God, we thank you. Father, I'm asking you, I'm thanking you for the work that you will do within our sister's son. Father God, I'm asking you in the name of Jesus that you continuously to raise him up, that you go by and you touch him right now, that you continuously touch him and do a work. I thank you that you go by and touch Sister Michelle and her family, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you do a work within them, Father God, that you lay your mighty hands upon them, Father God, in the name of Jesus. That you go by and touch Sister Shirley in the name of Jesus. That you do a mighty work within her. That you go by and touch Sister Pam for Kenny G. That you touch her mind. That you renew her mind daily. That you do a mighty work within her. That you raise her up. That you bind every spirit that will try to hinder her from running this race. That you bind every spirit that try to stop her from being the daughter that you call her to be. In the mighty name of Jesus, I give you all glory tonight. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen and amen. God bless each one of you. And I will see each one of you, God's will, tomorrow. To God be the glory. Amen. Sister Tammy, love you. Love you, love you. Love you. Yes, help your tomorrow, Lavenders, be joyful and to be really a day of peace. And may God protect each one of us. And may he keep COVID. May he put a hedge around each one of us. May he put a hedge around each one of us. In the name of Jesus. That COVID don't touch any of us in the name of Jesus, but that he protect us from it, that the blood will keep us from it in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen and amen. To God be the glory. I will see you all. Sister Caroline, love you.